I try not to keep any junk food in the house. So if you open cupboards in my kitchen, you will rarely find junk. If he likes, like my son likes chatpata food and whatever. So I try and make, so like when, while like I was giving you one of the recipes, roast the almonds, add some masalas to it, air fry the potatoes, add some chaat masala on it. If he's really hungry, tell him that, okay, while I'm getting the food that you like, the butter chicken that you like or something else that you like, have a little bowl of salad and I'm getting you the food. So what happens is that the moment you have something healthy first, even if it is in a small quantity, automatically what you're eating is not going to be that much of junk. You will eat a little less. So when he's hungry, the bargain is that when you're hungry, you will have one bowl of something healthy that mama gives you, and then you can have what you want to have. So we kind of keep striking those bargains, and as he's growing older, he himself is starting to make certain choices. In which, what the other thing that we work on is that, okay, we are on holiday, you can choose whatever you want to eat, but now we are not on a holiday, so we need a certain kind of life. So like we get up on time, we have to work out, we study, and in the same way we eat healthy. And holiday time is the binge time when you, you know, you can stay up later, you can watch videos and you can watch YouTube and you can watch whatever, your movies, or play as much as you want, and you can eat a bit of junk also at that point of time. So that kind of, I think, balances the year for us. So that's kind of started very early in life. So initial years, like the beginning, when I had the option, I just never showed him the option of junk food. So he didn't know it existed. I tried to keep that on for a couple of years so that by the time, you know, when he actually started realizing about junk food and looking at others eating it and everything, I could get into the zone where I could, you know, kind of talk with him about it and, you know, explain things to him. And when just an explanation didn't work, then we bargained about it. And then I said, this is the reward and this is the, you know, so in that zone kind of made it very clear from the beginning that it was important to make the right choices in food. For me, I carry my almonds in my bag because I'm snacking on them all the time. You know, sometimes you get caught up in a meeting, you get you know, something is exciting, you're discussing it and you don't realize you're hungry. And then when you get into the car and you suddenly realize, my God, I should have grabbed a meal, but I'm in the car, now I'm stuck in traffic. By the time I get to a place where I can get a meal, which is good, I'm going to be so hungry that I'm sure I'm going to choose the French fries. So before I can go and attack those French fries because my hunger is killing me, I just have a couple of almonds. It calms me down, gives me that little time where I can still go and make a healthy choice in food. So for me, almond is just like a go-to savior. Always in my car, in my bag, I carry it around everywhere. Where my son is concerned, yes, it's not like he was very, very fond of almonds, but, you know, make them interesting where he's concerned. I also chop them up a lot and use them in different ways, you know. So instead of using like a corn flour or something like that for a coating on a, say, a veg cutlet, there are times when I kind of coat it with really like finely shredded almonds, like really powdery almonds. Make that thing and, you know, pan fried. Makes the cutlet interesting, makes it healthier. I'm not using corn flour, I'm using crushed almonds. So it just makes it crunchier also. I do that a lot in the grills and all that also, use it a lot. And just as snacks also, use them with different masalas. You know, in India, you use it with some tandoori masala and, you know, with pepper. It makes it interesting and they become like, though they are almonds in 3-4 flavors, almonds in wasabi, because my son likes Japanese food, so I do almonds in wasabi for him and he finds it interesting. So they become 3 types of snacks, you know, though they are only almonds, but because they're 3 different flavors, they become 3 types of snacks. So it's interesting to, you know, do all these kind of things and make it something that appeals to the taste buds also. I started my career I was always genetically very thin. But I keep telling everybody, I don't think being thin is good. I think what you need to be is fit. So I was thin, but I was definitely not fit. Not healthy, not fit. So that was I started working out really late in life. So now I'm looking at building my muscle. And, you know, I understand that at my age, my muscle is my best friend. It's going to hold everything up. Gravity is taking its toll. So, yeah, in that sense, so my workout is important. I'm very, very particular about it. I do eat healthy. I enjoy healthy food. And when I don't, also I make sure that I have a healthy meal. And sleep is very important. You know, the moment you don't sleep enough, you are going to crave food which is not that healthy, because you will want more salt, more sweet, you know, the whole balance goes off. Your workouts suffer. So the sleeping is very, very important. And I don't think it has to be 8 hours or whatever. Whatever your body needs. Like for me, 6 hours is enough. And a less of a 4 hours, I can function at it. But some people need 8 hours, some people need 10 hours. So you need to figure out what your body needs, and that is very, very important. So I think that working out, sleeping well, and eating healthy are three things that are the most important things. They're a little difficult to do. There's no shortcut. There are a lot of people who will tell you various shortcuts, which will probably make you lose the weight, but will also make your hair fall, your skin go bad, your hormones go all over the place. So I feel that there is no shortcut to it. And I also feel like your sleep pattern, your body is your body type. Understand your body type. Make optimum, make it look the best of what the type it is. Dress it well, pamper it. But don't try to make it into some sort of a unreasonable body type, which it is not. So everybody doesn't have to look the same. The beauty of human beings is that we all look different. And that, I think, is one of the most important lessons. You have to accept your body at what it is at certain age. I have had a child, I'm at a certain age. I'm going to have certain pockets which are going to be very difficult to lose. And I will learn to live with them and hide them by dressing them a certain way. And that, I think, is the natural way of doing it.